Hey, what's going on, guys? My name's Dynasty. What I got for y'all today is another Mortal Kombat video. And over the years, it's been like a really weird situation, I think, with like NetherRealm Studios and their MKX mobile game. And what I mean by that is, MKX mobile probably has probably like some of the coolest skins ever inside of Mortal Kombat, and they're not on the home console versions of Mortal Kombat X. So for those who are not aware, pretty much after MKXL dropped a couple years ago, even after that, the mobile version of MKX got continued support. As recent as just last month, brand new characters with these cool skins have continued to be released every other month, and at this point in time, there still has never been any, I guess, answer behind why we'll never see these mobile skins transferred over to the console version. And I think NetherRealm Studios is missing the boat, because I know WB loves money. This is a super easy cash grab, essentially, if they were to ever release like a Mortal Kombat X mobile skin pack for the console version of MKXL. So in today's video, giving you guys my top 5 favorite skins I really do wish would be implemented inside the console versions of Mortal Kombat X. I'm telling you at this point in time right now, even just 3 years after the launch of MKX, people would buy these skins. So NetherRealm Studios, hey, I doubt you guys will ever do it, but maybe, just maybe, you should add these mobile skins to the console version because they're pretty kick-ass. Now, before we kick into the video, I want to remind you guys that just recently, I got sponsored by the good guys over at Now Drinks, and essentially, Now Drinks is a healthier alternative to your everyday energy drink. It has zero caffeine, low calories, low sugar, just primarily based using premium quality ingredients. And of course, you're probably saying, Dynasty, it's healthy. Does it still taste good? Yes, it does taste good. You're gonna improve your reaction time, your memory. The best part though is probably that you're not gonna have that crash that you usually have at the end of a night after you've drinking like 3 or 4 energy drinks. So it's worth checking out. Of course, use code Dynasty for 10% off. Again, link down below. And with that said, let's get into it. So first things first, the very first skin I think that easily is my personal favorite in all of Mortal Kombat X. Like, it's not even in the game, but it's in the mobile version, and that's gonna be the Day of the Dead Katana. She looks so sick with the skin. Like, I've always been intrigued by the whole Day of the Dead culture growing up, and to see this skin implemented, I feel they really did miss the boat, because for instance, this could have been part of a Halloween DLC pack, and that could have been like the headliner skin, because it's just so cool seeing like the skull makeup, seeing the roses in her hair, seeing, you know, still having the blue color scheme along with the black. She looks so sick, honestly. And of course, the closest thing we'll ever have to this skin being inside the game is a PC mod, and of course you're seeing that gameplay in the background. So my personal favorite skin of all time for Mortal Kombat X, it's probably there. Like, it's this one, and it's probably Revenant Sub-Zero. So yeah, I really love this skin. NetherRealm Studios, you're missing the boat. It's so sick. I don't understand why this work of art was not implemented on a larger scale. Moving on though to the second skin, I feel was also, just like the last one, completely missed the boat, that being Punk Cassie Cage. Just look how different Cassie Cage looks in this costume in comparison to just everyday business as usual rocking my Spec Ops, you know, uniform. She looks completely different. It's a night and day difference. These skins really just transform the characters completely. And I mean, from the pink hair to the leather jacket to the Anarchy logo on her shirt, you know, she has the netting on her legs, she has this, you know, short shorts. She looks like a punk star, and it looks insane. And to think that, like I mentioned, just like the last one, these really unique, one-of-a-kind skins were added. Like, even as unique skin packs, you could have had Day of the Dead skin pack, you could have had Punk skin pack, you could have had, like, a Punk Johnny Cage, a Punk Liu Kang, a Punk, I don't know, Kotal Kahn. You know what I mean? Like, these could have all individually been themes for skin packs, and man, NetherRealm, what are you doing? Moving on though to the third one. Now this one is kind of unique. It's gonna be the Elder God Kenshi skin, because obviously Kenshi's really not an Elder God in the lore, so from a canon standpoint that really wouldn't make any sense. But most of these costumes, I guess, really aren't meant to be taken as canon. They're really not meant to be taken serious. For instance, I mean, we have Infrared Scorpion. That's completely out of left field. So yes, I think for, you know, from that standpoint, Elder God Kenshi could still happen. Of course, he's rocking the white hair, he has the glowing eyes. I know as somebody who used Kenshi from time to time, this looks a lot better than the skins that we had for Kenshi inside of Mortal Kombat X, so zero complaints on my end. I know if you're a Kenshi main, you probably agree with me. They could have also had an Elder God skin pack where these characters have white hair, glowing eyes. Obviously, don't just do that, add more to the costume. Make him look a lot more godlier, like an Elder God, and then boom, go from there. I think a lot of people would have really enjoyed that. So boom, Elder God Kenshi, Elder God skin pack. It could have happened. Moving on to the most recent MKX mobile skin that got released. That's going to be the Kombat Cup Johnny Cage. I think as recent as, I want to say May, this got released. Maybe it was June, but of course we had the World Cup this summer. So Johnny is rocking, again, a football or a soccer kit, depending on, you know, where you're located. I call it football. Americans usually call it soccer. But yes, he's rocking the football jersey. NetherRealm Studios themed as well. He has a man bun, as insane as that is, you know. So it's like a stereotypical soccer player in 2018. A man bun. He's got tattoos. You know, he's got both his arms have sleeves on him. Johnny Cage looking like a badass. I personally think this version of Johnny Cage looks a million times better than the skin that we got inside the Brazil skin pack. That skin looked cool for what it's worth, but this one, he actually looks like a soccer player in 2018, a footballer in 2018. So NetherRealm Studios, again, for the World Cup just recently. I think they also had this for, I think, Cassie Cage as well. You could have given a lot more characters like football kits, soccer kits, and I think a lot of people, with the World Cup being as big as it was, would have probably jumped on that idea. Also, throwing the fact that, you know, man bun Johnny Cage, like, kind of get Kotal Kahn with a man bun? That'd be pretty cool. And last but not least, trying to narrow it down to a fifth one was kind of difficult. So I figured, hey, two is probably better than one, right? So here are two skins for Scorpion that I think would have just been so sick to have inside of Mortal Kombat X. This one being the Spec Ops Scorpion skin, where he's rocking a Call of Duty ghost or like a Black Ops mask. And of course, he's rocking also just a bunch of gray and black inside his default costume. Still some yellow, some gold here and there. His eyes are also glowing gold yellow. And he looks sick. That mask, though, looks so intimidating on Scorpion. And the second skin being the Hellspawn Scorpion skin. You see the trend, Nick. These are pretty much default costumes, slightly altered. So I figured that's kind of why they could be as, you know, two for one. It's pretty much the classic costume, but of course he has the classic toasty fatality, his skull flaming there as you're using him. So having either or of these options, you know, to choose from, would have been sick. Obviously, they could have probably done a lot more for the actual costume itself, but the idea of seeing Scorpion in all black, rocking just like a Call of Duty-esque, like, face mask, like he's in the Marines, and seeing Scorpion with his, you know, without his mask, with his, you know, his flaming skull 24/7, that would have been sick. They had Gold Scorpion as, like, a collector's edition exclusive. I think Hellspawn Scorpion would have been a lot cooler. Having just, you know, a chance to see Scorpion always with his, you know, his skull on fire. That would have been so sick. So anyways, that's going to be my top five. I guess you can say six skins from Mortal Kombat X Mobile that I feel deserved a rightful spot inside the console version of Mortal Kombat X. You have Day of the Dead Katana, Punk Cassie, Kombat Cup Johnny, Elder God Kenshi, Spec Ops Scorpion, and last but certainly not least, Hellspawn Scorpion. It's a shame because, like I mentioned, individually, they're great skins, but inside of packs based off of those character themes, NetherRealm Studios had like four different skin packs they could have made off of Kombat Cup, Elder God, Day of the Dead, and Punk. Like, even right now at this point in time, I think universally, a majority of us agree that we would have all purchased those skin packs. And I mean, it is what it is. They pretty much did the exact same thing for Injustice 2 and Injustice 2 Mobile. If I'm not mistaken, Injustice 2 Mobile got a bunch of other exclusive character skins, and I think even characters in comparison to Injustice 2. So it's just something that, unfortunately, NetherRealm Studios does. And I guess maybe because mobile games, it's like people spend more money on mobile these days in comparison to like actually buying DLC for consoles, I guess. And maybe that's why it's more of a grind on mobile and people actually don't mind spending on mobile. Maybe that's the reason, but I still think it's a missed opportunity. And I think that even now for both games, if they were released, a lot of these skins eventually, people would buy them. So hey, NetherRealm Studios, get your act together, because more content is more happiness. Even if I have to pay for it, if it's quality, I'm not going to complain. If you guys did enjoy this video, please drop a like on it. Make sure to subscribe for some more Mortal Kombat 11, Soul Calibur 6 content. And let me know, what other skins inside of the mobile game missed the cut that you wish would have been implemented inside of, you know, both Injustice 2 and Mortal Kombat X? Very curious, of course. If you guys want to subscribe, that'd be great, like I mentioned. And until next time, been your host, been Dice. Take care, stay safe, and I'll see you guys later. Peace. Setups, you one of the greatest. You deserve more exposure, man. You underrated. To all the dynasty haters, promise you'll love them later. Y'all gon' react like he did when he seen the trailer. But hold up, let me hit y'all with a twist. Wait, I'm Sub-Zero. The rap game is the Lin Kuei. You see, I've been a fan of dynasty for years now. GTA, MK, and Justice. I'm still down.